Right, here we are again, folks. Another year of the UK hi-fi, the ultimate high-end hi-fi experience. The last time I filmed this on my channel was 3 years ago, pre-COVID. So hope you enjoy yourself on this one. And as you can see, we're back at Ascot again. And yeah, it's quite an impressive place, actually, Ascot. But as you saw in my previous video, you saw quite a lot of it, actually, didn't you, really? I think you saw this part. But yeah, look at this. A very, very impressive enclosure. Right, off I go. I think my brother-in-law's in the distance. See if I can catch up with him. Right, I'm gonna cut this video now and restart as soon as I get in. I've got a lot of stitching of videos to do today when I get back on iMovie. But there we go. Look at this. Yep, very nice place indeed. God, the size of this place, my God. There we go, Ascot. Yep. Let's have a quick film down here. I don't know if I filmed this last time, perhaps I didn't. But there we go. Not bad, eh? Right, let me go find my brother-in-law and I shall see you later. Right, okay. Right, welcome back again. So I've had to stitch all these videos together. Right, the first room we've reached is the monitor audio group room, and I'm now going to proceed inside, but I'm not sure whether the copyright will affect the YouTube, my YouTube channel, I really don't know. But anyway, we shall soon find out. Right, here we go. Right. Monitor audio room. Oh. Wow. As I said, I'm not sure if the music will affect my copyright on this channel. I don't know. I hope not. Right, welcome back again. Okay, now I've just seen these beautiful monitor audio speakers and they're ebony finished, by the way. Just want to talk to the guy here who's the representative of Monitor Audio. So,
I am.
Thank you for doing this little interview.
You're very welcome, you have no problem at all. So yeah, what we have here is our PL100 bookshelf speakers or stand mount speakers, £4,500 a pair. Finished in our ebony real wood.
Okay.
17 layers of lacquer. Monitor Audio is well known for its craftsmanship in the quality of its cabinetry. And I think the Platinum Series 3G, just recently launched into the UK, really exudes that sort of quality. They utilise our MPD3 ribbon transducer at the front,
yep,
with a 6.5-inch RDT3 drive unit. Very, very powerful motor systems behind that. Those driver cones are made out of a very three layers of material. A C cam, which is a ceramic coated aluminium magnesium, with a honeycomb Nomex material inside the sandwiches. Then, and then we have two layers of carbon weave behind it, and it makes the cone very, very pistonic, very, very lightweight, very strong. As I say, big motor systems behind it, very, very capable loudspeaker. And yeah, they stand on the ST2 stand, so it's £500 a pair.
Right.
Which can be mass loaded and it's got cable management, so you can keep a nice clean aesthetic.
That's beautiful. Right, thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Yeah, if you check out Harvey's Vintage Audio, so it's HARVEY
Harvey's Vintage Audio.
Harvey's Vintage Audio, I can't say myself.
Go and check it out.
Okay, great. Yeah, I normally specialise in reel to reel, the early old reel to reel technicals like Revoxes and earlier Brunels and all that. But have a look, but the channel is building up quite rapidly, so but yeah, thank you very much for that. And hopefully, right, did you hear that, guys? Right, if you're going to buy a decent pair of speakers, have a look at these Monitor Audios, because they are phenomenal. And just rewind the video and you can hear the specs on it and specifications on it now. Okay? Right, thank you very much. Thanks very much. Bye. Thank you. Right, there we go. That's the monitor audio speakers there. Right, so we're going to proceed now to the next section here. Okay, there we go. What have we got here? MBL. See, this place is filled full of rooms, and in these rooms are all different contributors, all different hi-fi retailers, or sellers rather, manufacturers. Let me get it right. So there we go. Right. That was good. All right, next. We're in the Hagel, and I've never heard of this company before, but Hagel, is it? Hagel Music Systems, right, okay, so let's proceed. Oh, interesting. Hagel Music Systems. That's got Res Pulse in the back room. Interesting gear. Right, yes. Off we go. Oh. Sweetie. Little sweetie. Thank you, Rich. Right, okay, look at this. It's a wonderful day as well here at Ascot. It's wonderful. Look at the view here. This is amazing. Look at this. Why do you think me and my brother-in-law like coming here? Well, last 3 years it's been postponed due to COVID. But I think we were here 2019, last visit. If you look on my YouTube channel, you will see my past video on here. So there we go. There we go. Look at this. Wonderful place. Wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. So we got decent audio. Alright, good name. Decent audio. Whether they're decent or not, who knows? Right, next room, here we go. Right, where are we here now? Let's see. Right. Oh, decent audio. Here we go.
CD and integrated, so DX8 integrated.
Decent audio sound systems. Right. Now they're nice, they're unusual.
Right.
Very simple, so. All the nice
rooms. Doing show reports and photography.
Show reports and reviews.
Right.
But as I'm in Germany, my main gig is Image Hi-Fi.
What's this? A disc cleaning machine.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah. That's a nice one to get, Rich. No? That's a nice disc cleaning machine there. Right, here we go. There's a nice disc cleaning machine. I wouldn't mind one of those, actually. Yeah. Especially when I'm playing my beloved Pink Floyd albums. I mean, they're all original from the 70s in mint condition. There we go. That's probably the founder of the company here. I think. No, who is that? I don't know who that is. Oh, no, it's not hi-fi related, sorry. Not hi-fi related, that's something to do with a race course. Silly boy, Harvey. Oh, good God. Oh, what's this now? I tell you what, you know I had a bad ankle for the last 3 weeks. Well, it's getting better, thank God. I was praying to God my ankle would get better before this show. So I didn't want to let my brother-in-law down. Uh-uh. They already pre-bought the tickets as well, you know. So... look at this lovely place, I just love it here. Oh, it's nice and breezy here too, because I'm getting rather hot. Wearing a bloody woolly shirt. Shouldn't have done that, but I did. I did. Ah, okay. I don't think I filmed this. You know, there's a train strike today. So maybe that's why there's not that many people here. Yeah, Yet again, the British Railways on this country, if you're watching from America, they're on strike again today, as usual, and again on Wednesday. Because I haven't seen many people yet, unless they're all suffering from a hangover from the night before, because today's a Saturday, and normally people like going out and getting drunk on a Friday night. So maybe that's why there's a lack of people here today so far. Or it could be just we're a little bit early because it's only coming up to 10 o'clock. But there we go. I'm trying to keep this video as long as possible because I don't want to stitch a whole load of videos together with iMovie. That's why I'm still filming, by the way. Right, what did I miss 3 years ago? So I missed a lot of contributors. Right, there you go. Ooh, they're nice. So, I wonder if they're ceramic, ceramic magnets. It's a bit dark here, so I apologise for the quality. Okay. Oh, these are unusual. Bloody heck. Look at these, Rich. See these? Look, they look like carbon fibre. Hopefully rubber surrounds, not foam. I just, as you know what I'm like. I don't like buying foam surround speakers because you know what happens to foam surround speakers? Yes. After about 5-6 years, they crumble to nothing. Then you've got to re-cone your speakers. It's like my Celestion Ditton 44s I bought in 1975. Are they still going? Yes, they are. You know why? Because they're rubber surrounds. And they use good quality rubber, which don't deteriorate. Hopefully, these speakers have got rubber surrounds. But there we go. Right, okay. I'm still filming. Still filming away here. Otherwise, I've got too much video editing to do. I'm just wondering, the lack of people today must be due to the train strike. Yes, they're on strike again for more money. Greedy sods. Karma. Karma Audio. Shall we have a quick look in here? Look at this. Is Karma. Karma AV. Okay. Karma AV. You have a special place in my heart. Wow, look at this. Let's sit down for a second. My ankle's kidding me. Yes, my ankle's still hurting, folks. Actually, my phone is plugged into one of these 2000 milliamps power banks, so I don't run out of power. Yep, it's surviving quite well. I'll see how the test goes, and I might recommend one on my channel, my YouTube channel. Sound really nice though. See the speakers, they're very slim like, but they sound good. So please make a note, people, of Karma Audio Visual. There we go. Oh, hello there. Sorry, so I've got a YouTube channel, Vintage Audio, Harvey's Vintage Audio.
Yeah, okay.
So I hope you don't mind me just publicising your products.
No, no problem.
Okay, great. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Right. Very impressive speakers, I must admit. I'm not sure, so I'm talking to my brother-in-law at the moment. Let me see, I'm not sure if there's anything else, Rich. I think we came to this section last time, and that was the end, then we had to turn back again. What's this? Karma AV. Karma, oh, bloody ankle still hurts, you know, folks. I'm not kidding. Don't know what I did. Nah. Right, we're going to turn around here. Right, I'm going to cut this video for a second. Because I've made about 3 videos so far. I'm going to join them. As you know, you're not going to see any difference once I join them all together. It's just going to be one continual video. But let me just stop this for a little while and I'll get back to you very shortly. Right, welcome back, folks. Right, we're on another section at the moment, and this is the record section, LPs. And as you can see, we've got a lovely view of Ascot in the background. Beautiful place. Right, it's quite a few LPs here, actually. Look at that, a nice Bowie set there. Look at that. Yeah, I've got a lot of work to do when I get back. I need to stitch all these videos together. And yeah, there's a lot of work, but never mind. I use iMovie, it's quite simple. Oh, look, it's Bob Dylan. Bob Dylan. Oh, now that looks good. Oh, the Beatles in mono, look at that. That's a great LP set. Oh, yeah. Nice price, too.
Anyway, all the best.
1,100. So I'm just doing a YouTube video for my vintage audio channel. Hope you don't mind.
Not at all.
Very good. Okay. Yeah. Thank you very much. Right. Just because this goes all over America, all over the place, all over the world, everywhere. Right. Then that is nice. And I wouldn't mind that. I'll have to check my lottery ticket first, though. Wow. It's a little bit above my price range, but all the Beatles albums in mono. Wow. Unbeatable. Because, as you know I like restoring all the old Brenel mono machines, and I like playing around with the old Revox two-track machines. And, well, in my, you know, I'm a big fan of Joe Meek as well, and he mainly recorded in mono. And that's the format I actually prefer, to be honest. But there we go. Okay, so thank you very much. Thanks. Right, okay, as you can see, there are a lot of LPs here. Hell of a lot. Beach Boys. Oh, look at that. Early Beach Boys. Very nice. I think I have this album actually somewhere. £35? Worth it, I guess, yeah. Now, I've definitely got this album, the Simon Garfunkel one. My dad bought it originally. Oh, this is autographed. Oh my God, look at that, folks. Wow. Now, that is rare. And that's worth every penny in my books, £100. That's autographed. That is worth every penny, that one. I'm bloody hot at the moment. I can't really take the shirt off. There we go. Lost my brother-in-law. Oh, there he is, sitting there. Right, next section. Okay. And my ankle is still hurting me. I know I keep going on about it, but it is. Oh, Hannah cartridges. Never heard of that company before. Well, well, well. Hannah. Right. I'll see you in the next section. I'm going to cut it for a second. Right, welcome back again. As I said, these videos will be just one continual video because, as I said, I'm filming this all in little sections. So I just can't film everything, even though I do have the capacity to film for hours because I've got the very powerful power bank here. So it's still going, 2,000 milliamperes an hour, so that's all right. Hannah. Now, I've never heard of Hannah before, but even 3 years ago when I was here last, I never heard of Hannah, but apparently... oh, hello there. Hi. So I'm doing a video for my vintage audio channel,
right.
Harvey's Vintage Audio.
Okay. Well, Hannah are made by XL Sound in Japan.
Right.
They're a 50-year-old company.
Uh-huh.
And they basically launched their own brand, having OEM'd for all the other moving coil companies.
Ah, really? All right. That's interesting.
Which they still do actually sell a lot of OEM. But their Hannah brand is 6 years old, and it's just about won every award in the world. I mean, they are remarkably good value for money.
Right, you hit right, you hear that, folks? Hannah, make a note of the name and check them out. Oh, now look at that. That is nice. That is a lovely turntable. And just slightly shy of 5,000.
Yes.
Not bad.
Yes.
Yeah, nice pickup on there.
Yep. And it comes with quartz control, speed control.
Right.
With,
okay.
With actual independent speed, so you can get it absolutely spot on.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
And is it just got the regular speeds? Because you know what? It's funny though, because...
I don't do 78, but I own 45 and
33. Right, fair enough, yeah. Because it's funny though, because you know, fashion goes in one big circle, and apparently 78s are coming back.
Wow.
Whether they, you know, there's many around or not. I mean, I actually collect 78s, believe it or not.
Mm.
It's just that raw sound. Sorry, yes. I'm not pointing to it. That raw sound of 78s sort of crackling and scratching, and but you know. Yep, that is nice. That is very nice. Thank you very much.
That's
thank
right.
you.
Pleasure.
Right, now that's very interesting. So keep a lookout. Do a search for Hannah on Google. Ah, that is interesting. Right. So I've got my brother-in-law next to me now. We're walking along. And what's next? This is actually going to be a very nice video when it's all stitched together. I don't think I actually filmed any of this last time either. Look at that, look at the architecture. Hell. Amazing. Oh, what have we come to here? Sorry, it's a bit dark here, the lighting's a bit crappy. No. Where are we here? Where are we here? Node. So I'm just filming for my vintage audio channel.
Yeah,
Harvey's Vintage Audio, if you want to check it out.
Nice, no, thank you.
Yeah.
We've got, if you want to video them in action, we've got a listening room just down there on the right.
Okay, all right then, great. Yeah. Now these are interesting, that's all. Very interesting speakers here, people. All right. Lighting's a bit poor, sorry about that, but no, I still don't know how to turn the light on these things. These iPhones, I don't know. Cool. Right, okay, thank you very much.
Can you get the door for you to get on?
Yeah, okay, thank you. I appreciate that.
That's all right.
Thanks very much. Thank you. All right, there we go. Oh, there's some interesting stuff here this year. In fact, there's a lot of stuff here I didn't see 3 years ago. So whether they're brand spanking new companies. Oh, here we are. This new room. But I better go in. Right, now.
Yeah,
right, those speakers you just saw, this is their listening room.
No, and I think so it's a bit the dark. Nice thing about these is they're,
because
of the shape of them, you don't get the pressure that you would from a square box where you get the sort of smearing of the sound of plexus. So you can move around the room and the sound's even, and you don't lose the stereo image, which is quite nice. And then the crossover exists down here in the stanchion, sort of magazine loaded underneath the speaker, so it's away from the magnetic fields. The finish is fully customizable, so we paint in any color effectively, and we do pearlescence, metallics, anything really. These fascia plates, they're not just press bits of steel, these are machined from solid billets of aluminium, and then we polish them and have them plated. So these are nickel plated, but we do rose gold, 24 karat gold.
Oh gosh.
And match the inlay badge here. Similar to the base, we can mirror polish that as well, so fully customizable. Of course, the price reflects that as you kind of move up. But yeah, this room primarily we are showing the isolators, so this is kind of our launch weekend of these products. So these are effectively like an acoustic drain, so they go underneath your equipment, they'll drain the vibrations down through this gimbaling stainless steel top section.
Yeah.
So you can always get a perfect contact to your bottom of your equipment. That'll pull the vibration energy into the ceramics inside here, but it also focuses magnetic fields. You can imagine in something like the Melco, you've got a transformer over here, you've got sensitive clocks and stuff in there.
Yeah.
So it makes a huge difference to actually focus that magnetic field in one place so it doesn't sort of leak and colour other components. So positioning of that.
How much is a set of those? And you get six in a set, yeah?
So we're selling them in sets of three or four, but we'll happily sell you two sets of three.
Oh, sorry, yes, I saw the six holes or something.
Yeah, so we can use this box to sell
two sets of three
per box. So they're $675 for a set of three, but we're doing a show special of $540 for the launch weekend. I think we've got eight sets left, so not many sets left at the moment, but. And we're saying to people, look, try them at home. If you're not happy, send them back.
Okay.
Money back. Guarantee. No questions asked. Let's have a look. Let's see.
Right. Just popping out, isn't it? I'm hot. Oh, tell you what. This weather for the time of year is very unseasonal. Tomorrow is the 1st of October, and let me tell you something, right? We're going to have a mini heat wave for the first 2 weeks in October. It's going to go up to 24 centigrade. If you're in the States, you'll have to work that out yourself in Fahrenheit, but there we go. Right, yeah, so apparently it's going to go up to 24 centigrade, and today I'm feeling rather hot. But there we go. I must remember when I'm on my channel and I'm filming, do not swear, Harvey. So I've kept it very clean, and so you should be proud of me. There we go. Right, next section. Okay, we'll be back. Right, welcome back again. Yeah, as I said, I've got to stitch all these videos together now. We've reached this section here, Moon by Sim Audio, North Collection. Explore new frontiers. And no man has gone before. Shut up, Harley. Renaissance, there we go. Blah, blah, blah. Two, that means they've got two rooms, 501 to 503. Okay, let's have a look. I might have to keep quiet because it's a listening room, okay? There we go, let's have a look. Oh, there we go. Right, now this is the listening room. Look at that Ascot. Look at this. This is actual Ascot race course. Amazing, eh? Amazing view. Ascot race course. Amazing. Wow. Nice equipment. Well, I must admit, some very nice equipment here. Look at those speakers. Using the streamer there, so the streamer unit. Copyright's going to affect YouTube, but I better stop for a second. Right, I'm just going to film this turntable from the same company. It's rather extraordinary. Look at that. Wow. Oh my god. It's amazing. Folks, I'm back again. This is the headphone section where people are trying out all different brands of headphones. Yeah, it's a bit noisy, so I apologize for the look at that view of that race course. It's phenomenal, isn't it? There we go. But yeah, all different manufacturers of headphones here. Yeah. Everyone's all trying.
You got the Dave, the M scale there.
Oh yeah, your one. So I'm talking to my brother-in-law at the moment. Yeah, it's got the same unit. My brother-in-law's got the same unit. Well, he has, because I've seen it. What am I saying apparently for? Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that. Anything with tubes I love, as you know. I'm a tube fanatic, or valve fanatic. Tube if you're in the States, valve if you're in the UK. But, oh, look at that. I like it. I like the way you stop singing, Harvey. You're doing a hi-fi video, right? Yeah. there is some really unusual gear which we didn't see 3 years ago. And everything seems to be going back to tubes or valves if you're in the UK. What is this company here? Right, Focal. There we go, Focal. Nice headphones. These. Can't try in at the moment, so I'm filming, so, but never mind. Ooh. Oh, really? Name. There we go. Another brand quality is name. They make very good gear. Absolutely 100%. So, okay. I'm so glad I brought this power bank with me because I ran out of power last time. Well, I nearly did. I nearly ran out of power. No, actually, I did. So, if you look at the last video 3 years ago, I was filming this very unusual hi-fi, headphone amplifier, and I did run out of power. I had to stop filming. But, there you go. Oh, and I'm hot AF. Can't swear. Hot AF. Hot as AF. I'm very hot. Look at this place. It's really nice here, you know. So thank you to my brother-in-law Richard for bringing me here and paying for my ticket too. So thanks, Rich, if you're watching this. I know you are. I know you will be. And there we go. Look at that. Right, I'm going to stop filming for a second and I shall restart very soon. I've got so much work to do joining these videos together. But see you in a second. As I said, it's going to be one continuous video when you view it. But for me, it's not. It's all separate sections. There we go. Right, there we go. Welcome back again. Right, this is a company called Cord, and they make audiophile cables, specialist cables, and they are quality cables, but there's a lot of people that disagree on cabling. You know, some people say, well, you know what, you can just use ordinary mains cable and you get the same sort of quality, but it's all up to the individual whether they decide to lay at the expense for the cables or not. I'm not gonna say yay or nay to any of these, but that's supposed to be like a mains filter cable. But the decision is all yours. I'm not going to say yay or nay to anything. I guess. Yeah, but there we go. Look at that. Yeah, I'm not gonna plug cables, you know. As I say, I just use sort of standard cabling, something like mains cabling from my loudspeakers, or even QED 36 strand cable. I've been using that for years. All up to the individual again. And there we go. Right.
Yeah, good. Thanks.
Yep. Right, okay, here we go. Right, welcome back, folks. We're at the name section here. This is name audio. Got a bit of film names, because names are one of the top companies in the UK. So there we go. There we go. Look at this name gear. Oh, yes. Oh, the new style, eh? Streamer. And then streamer there. Lighting's a bit off, I'm sorry about the lighting, folks, but there we go. Yeah. This is a demo, is it? Sound demo. Let me get down lower. You might get a better view of this all. Oh. See, the light's against us. You've got a light in the background, so it might not come out clearly. lovely view of the race course again. Right, so that's the new style of main gear. It's a brand new style. That's a nice rack actually, I love that rack. Very nice. Right, okay then folks. Right, I don't know if I'll be filming anymore. I'm not sure if there's much more to film, to be honest. Right, I might talk to you later. Right, I'm back again. There we go. Now this is quite nice. Manly Maha.
Look at that. Very nice.
All tubes or valves. Look at that. You see how the fashion goes in one big circle. You know, there's one point where nobody wanted valve gear anymore, and it's all coming back again, as always. Fashion is a big circle. Very nice stuff. But there we go. I'm gonna I might even grab a brochure, actually. Yes, I'm gonna grab one. My Fidelity. I just can't grab one of those. Wow. These are nice. Sure. And right, see you all later then. I'll probably make a few more parts, I'm not sure yet, but we'll find out later. Right, let me cut this video for a minute. I'm still filming. Right, let's cut this. Right, here we go folks, back again. Now this is nice here. Now this is a company called Absolute Sounds. And they have got some very crowded here, sorry there. There we go, Absolute Sounds demo area. Some really nice gear here. God almighty. Look at that. Yep, so there we go. It might be the last bit of film I'm doing actually, for the time being. Might have to wait till next year, but I mean, how can they really improve on all this stuff? Look at that. I think I filmed this last time, I think 3 years ago, pre-COVID. That is nice. I'm gonna take a flyer. As you say in the States, we call them leaflets over here because we're posh. I think in the States you call them flyers, but there we go. I'm gonna grab a flyer. There we go. Grabbing a flyer. Put my little bag. I'll put that away in a second. There we go. Wow, that's, look at that. That is nice, I must admit. That is absolutely beautiful. My God. Some really nice gear here, folks. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Gosh, that is nice. I'm frightened to ask the price, actually. Very frightened to ask the price of that. Because I might drop dead and have a heart attack. So, I'm not going to ask the price. Yeah. Now I've lost my brother now. Where's he gone? Right. Okay, I'm going to find my brother-in-law now because I've just lost him. Now there we go, right, talk to you soon, maybe later, maybe not, I'm not sure yet. See what else there is to see. Right, sorry, I nearly missed this section out. This is Absolute Sounds again. And as I said, I'm going to join it all up anyway. But they have got some really nice gear. I mean, you saw the those silver amps, they're beautiful. All tubes, yet again, tubes are coming back. And I saw that years ago. I said, you know what? People have thrown away their old tube amps, but tubes are coming back, or valves. That one, I don't know why. That always reminds me of an old fire, an old electric fire from years ago. We used to have these electric fires in the UK years ago, I don't know. And it just reminds me of an electric fire. I don't know what it is, but they do, but they're nice. At least it's got lots of ventilation for those valve tubes to breathe. I'm sure they get very hot. Very nice. Is there any prices here? I'm not sure if they put the prices to. I don't think they want people to get heart attacks. So.
If you want to know the price, you can't afford it.
No, I know.
But
no,
that's what he's saying.
Yeah, someone was disagreeing with me just now about the prices. They don't really display the prices because they are pretty expensive. Oh, did I show you the turntables? No, I didn't. Right, turntables over there. Hold up.
Oh, it's a hybrid one. It's a preamplifier. Oh, it's a preamplifier, that's why.
No, that's a nice
thing. That's why. It's got some
valves in it. And the power one.
Oh. That's another nice turntable there. Oh, that is nice. Now that is nice. That integrated amp. But as I've said it before, it's all beyond my price range until I win the lottery. So there we go. Yeah, I think I showed you these amps 3 years ago, guys. I'm sure I did. Yeah. Yeah, you have seen these before. So the styling hasn't changed much in 3 years, so there we go. Oh, now. Now that is, oops, sorry. Now that is nice. Right, it's a bit crowded area, so I'm going to stop filming for a second. I'm not sure if I'm going to film anymore, as I said last time, but we'll see. Okay, bye for now. Outside here, I've never ever done this before, but this is the one of the enclosures. What do you call it? The enclosure? Well, all the seats are. That's got, I'm sitting on one of these seats here. Look at that. Wow, great view of the race course. My word. Let me stand up a minute. Look at that. Phenomenal. Ascot race course. Look at that. What an amazing place, and it's a lovely day as well, eh? It makes it all the better when the weather's lovely. It certainly does. What's, how's that saying going? I can see my house from here. Maybe not. There we are, look at this place. Phenomenal. Harvey, don't fall over now, don't fall out and kill yourself. Bloody hell. So there we go, the famous Ascot Racecourse. This might be the last video of the day. I'm not sure yet. See that music in the background, I'm not sure how that's going to affect the YouTube copyright. So this might be all blanked off, I might not even be able to upload this. Who knows? So I better keep it short. Right, we're somewhere where it says YG Acoustics. Now, I'm not sure how the copyright's going to affect YouTube on this one, but we shall soon find out when I upload it. I actually own something like that, believe it or not. Power amp. I must get it out one day. I bought it about 2 years ago and I haven't even unboxed it, so maybe there's a big pile of bricks in inside the box instead of an amp, I don't know. I bought something very similar. Can you believe it? Who does a thing like that? Buys something, doesn't even open the box. Only one person that can be, that's me. Well, there we go. I'm sure it's fine. And I will take it out one day and demonstrate it on my channel. And these are two mono blocks, by the way. One over there. And we have the other mono block over there. Very nice, very nice. Dual mono blocks. I don't think you've seen this last time I filmed over here, about 3 years ago, pre-COVID days. Right. Shall I stay for hours? Shall I go and change my point of view for every night? Oh, that's unusual. This is what you want to know. Now it's history, I see. Can't see the name for him. We've got the light against us, but never mind. Very nice. Better stop against the YouTube compliment. Okay. Right, welcome back. I know this is not Hi-Fi associated, but I just want to give you another quick glimpse of the Ascot Racecourse, because this is quite an advantaged position. Advantage, yeah, that's great. Nice advantage position of the race course. You don't normally get to see this, but there we go. Look at that. Isn't it magnificent? Ascot. Just think, the Queen, the ex-Queen of England, has frequented this place on numerous occasions. Can you imagine, eh? There you go. Let's do a slow scan of Ascot. It's massive, isn't it? Absolutely huge, this place. Look at that. Can you imagine what this place is worth in real estate? Oh my God, it must be worth what? 500 million? Easy. For all this land in prestigious Berkshire, probably worth a billion, actually. I wish I knew. I wonder if there's anything on Google about this. What is the land value of Ascot? Who knows? Anyway, this could be the final video. I know I keep saying it, but I always seem to bump into other things on the film. Now look at that. Beautiful, eh? I reckon it's worth about 600 million, 700 million, all this land. Easy or more. And there's a lot of real estate here. Look at this land. It's not real estate, it's just land, isn't it? I think that's the winner's enclosure down there, you know, when the horse wins. I don't know. Very nice. Right, I just thought I'd add it to the video in case you're a bit fed up of audio. Okay. Right, here we go. Just found another room with some really nice gear. Oh, look at that. Now that is nice. All tube, all valves. Oh, that's £15,000, that one. £15,000. Wow. £15,000. Would hardly spend £15,000 on one of those. No. No. If I had 100 million in the bank, would I buy one? Maybe. Look at that, that's nice. Right. Look at these loudspeakers, what the hell? Now, how unusual are these? God. Torrens deck, say. I used to sell these years and years and years ago, Torrens. the original Torrens, TD125s of Hinterburn. A long, long time ago, when I used to be a hi-fi salesman. Yeah, about a long time now. We've changed a lot over the years, I must admit, from the old Torrens TD125 hanging around. I've been summoned.
There's a PS audio guy who does all their videos.
Oh! Really? So I'm just doing it to my brother-in-law at the moment.
Videos, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
They're
great.
Appreciate that.
Hi there.
Hi.
Oh, sorry. So I'm just doing a YouTube video for my vintage audio channel. Harvey's Vintage Audio.
Specialised
in Reebok.
Okay.
Stuff like that. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you. So we've got a celebrity here, guys. There we go. Sorry, what's your full name again?
Paul McGowan.
Right, there we go. Yep. And what's your YouTube channel?
My YouTube channel? It's PS Audio or Paul McGowan, so...
Right, PS Audio. Okay, so subscribe PS Audio, guys, please, yeah? Okay, thank you.
Thanks.
There you go, no problem. Lovely sounding stuff, I must admit. Look at those speakers, they're beautiful. Here's a very, very interesting turntable I've just found. Look at that. You know what I'm like about Pink Floyd? Mega fanatic with Pink Floyd. Mega fanatic. Now, this is really nice. Made by Project Audio. And it's a special edition, obviously. Dark Side of the Moon turntable. Look at that. Isn't that neat? Isn't that really nice? My God. Well, I know what I'm buying if I win the lottery, but that's probably expensive anyway. Don't think I can afford that. That's really fantastic, right? So if I get a lottery win tonight, I'm buying that. I'm going to buy it. What the hell? Right, what else we got? Oh, all right, hang on.
Remember the A1? You used to blow up in the old days?
Oh, yes. So I'm talking to my brother-in-law at the moment. Right, there we go. Oh, God, yes. Look at that.
Well, that's what he looks at.
Bloody hell, this is a revamp.
Revamp LS358, lovely finish.
And what was that problem you said, Rich?
In the old days, these A1s were Class A amps.
Right. And
people used them as like shoe scrapers. No, just joking.
But
they used to blow up because they got so hot.
Yeah, this overheat, that's right. I heard something about that. Well, this is a new revamp version, and hopefully this one won't have the issues the first generation had. Well, there we go, look at that. Oh, some
these are nice.
Nice little bookshelf speakers.
That's £2,500.
What? So I just nearly had a heart attack. These little speakers are £2,500. Right, I nearly swore there, I mustn't swear. Good God, £2,500. Now, that's an unusual deck, but you know what? I'll go back to that Pink Floyd turntable any day of the week. Let's go back to it. Oh, I missed that, the logo underneath. Look at that. Roger Waters or anybody in the Pink Floyd band, if you want to buy me something, could you please donate that to my channel, please? Thank you very much. I should be so lucky, wouldn't I? David Gilmour, no? If you're watching? Oh, look at that. That is beautiful. I don't even want to touch it. It's so nice. Imagine that in your front room, in your living room, eh? Even if you don't use the damn thing, it just looks great. Dun, 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 dun. Bum, 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 bum. Money! Get away! Don't give me that good, good, good bullshit. Money! It's a drag. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, this is very nice gear, folks. Yeah. Henley Audio. Yeah, some very nice gear here, by the way. Very unusual, look at that. I just lost my brother-in-law. Oh, there he is. I can see. I've got to put a hand out of thanks to my brother-in-law, because if it weren't for him, I wouldn't be here. So you got to thank my brother-in-law, Richard, for that. Oh, look at this, guys. Look at this. Now, this is nice. Now, this is very nice. Wow. Looks like this came out of a Superman movie from Planet Krypton. What do you reckon? That sort of icy look. Very nice. That was nice. There you go. What have we got now? Can't see because of light. So we got background light, so you won't be able to see this very clearly, unfortunately. But there we go. That turntable. Holy shit. I still prefer that Pink Floyd turntable, actually. What's behind this? Oh, XLRs and two phonos. That's a good sign. That is very nice, actually. That is so unusual. What do you reckon, guys? Nice turntable? Yeah. Wow. Very nice. Look at that deck, Rich. That is beautiful, isn't it? There we go, guys. 10 grand. What do you reckon? Oh, well, hopefully I'll have a lottery win tonight and might buy one. Who knows? You never know, right?
Kit's horn speakers.
Oh! Now, they're nice. Reminiscent of tannoys, look. See? One single cone. Beautiful. Oh, look at those. Look at some nice gear here, guys. Really, speakers, beautiful. They're quite big, actually. There you are. They're very, very big. Humongous, in fact. Now, I like those speakers very much. Now these speakers are very unusual. In fact, there's a cone at the rear and also at the front, which is pretty unusual, really.
Oh, sorry.
So they're the front of the speakers, and there's also got an extra cone at the back, which is very unusual. But I bet they sound great. There we go. That's really good. Going to browse along here somewhere. Oh, there we go. Henley Audio. Some of these turntables, wow, they're just amazing. But you know what, I've still got my Technics SL110 Mason E3009 arm, sure V15 Mark III cartridge, and I love it. I really do, you know. And I'll never sell it. I'll never sell my Technics SL110 SME arm combination. That'll never happen. Maybe when I'm dead and gone, they'll go on to somebody else. But there we go. That's the only trouble when you die. You've got to get rid of all your stuff. It doesn't belong to you ever again. What a horrible thought. Oh, yeah. That's life, I guess. It's terrible, isn't it, when you think about it? All right, I'm going to have a quick sit down now, because we've been walking miles here today. Anyway, there we go. Talk to you later. I keep saying talk to you later. And this is going to be one complete video to you, but to me it's not. It's all multiple video shots, barely. Right, here we are at the SME stand. I don't know if you can see it clearly because we've got background light again. But there are some really nice turntables. My brother-in-law had one, but he sold it. I still don't know why he sold it, but there we go. You'll have to ask my brother-in-law. But he had something similar to that. Similar to this one, actually. In fact, this is the one he had. Yeah, I think it was that one. Rich? That's the one you had, isn't it? Yeah. So I'll just confirm with him. That's the turntable he had, but he sold it. And I don't know why he sold it, because it's lovely. But there we go. Okay, there's another one there. Oh, that's a nice one. That is a nice one. Bloody hell. And remember, they're not cheap. Nowhere they're cheap. Can I actually touch one with my finger? Oh, I've done it. I've actually touched one. Naughty boy. Am I allowed to touch him? Who knows? So there we go. These are a few of the SME turntables here on display. And as I say, this one, I don't know which, I prefer this one actually, to be honest. Yeah, now this one, this is the one I would buy myself if I could afford it. But yeah. That's the controller unit. So 3345s on that. It's a controller unit for that. And that's exactly the one my brother-in-law had. It's identical to that one. That is the one. Still don't know why he sold it, but I don't know. But I think that's the one I would go for. Yeah. There we go. I don't know why I'm going to end there. I've got lots of editing to do later on, hell of a lot, before I upload it to my channel, but, you know, you've got to do what you've got to do. So there we go. Right. There might be another video, who knows. Right, I said I wasn't going to make another video, but I've just seen this Garrard 301, I think it is. Just, before the 401, I'm sure it is, 301. Have a little close-up on that. I'm sure it's the 301. Is it 201, 301? Oh, these glasses don't work. 301, I'm going to sue my optician because these glasses don't work. It's a 301, can you see it clear? You probably see it clearer than me, actually. Right, whatever it is, it precedes the 401, and that is one nice deck. Look at that. It is a 301, right, okay, there we go. It's a 301. That is beautiful. It's immaculate condition as well. Look at it. Good God. It's beautiful. Great British icons. There we go. Let's go back a bit more. There we go. Okay. Great British icons. Isn't that beautiful? I think Andy... you know Andy, I always forget his channel, Vintage Repair. I always forget your channel, Andy, sorry mate. But look, you would love one of these, wouldn't you? I bet you would. Benji, if you're watching. My mate Benji, look at this. Huh? Oh my God, that is a beautiful deck. Garrard 401. You're making too much noise, apparently. Shh. Right, there we go. Right, I'll talk to you later. Bye for now.